the day of the attack on America.
On September 11th, 2001, New York City was shaken to its core when two jet airliners crashed into the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center. Now the National Museum of Ireland, Collins Barracks, is hosting a major exhibition to commemorate the event. In the wake of the chaos, New York-based Irish photographer Nicola McLean responded in the only way she knew how. She picked up her camera and took to the streets to try and capture the confusion and panic that surrounded her. McLean now brings her stunning collection of images to the public for the first time. Through harrowing visuals, chilling audio clips, and a unique panoramic installation, Ground Zero 360 Degrees invites you to step into the past and feel what 8 million New Yorkers were feeling in the days that followed the attacks. Nicola is now married to Donegal man Paul McCormack, who was among the many brave police officers who helped New York during the attacks and in their aftermath. The couple created Ground Zero 360 Degrees. McCormack explains where the idea came from.
Well, the idea came from my wife Nicola. She was photographing down there on the day and in the days and weeks thereafter, and she was deeply affected by the whole incident down there, the people coming up to her, the families that were desperately searching for victims, and she wanted to do something with what she had, with the images that she took, to remember, to keep the memory alive, never forget this incident. And together we worked this out, this exhibition.
Officially opening the exhibition, the Minister for Arts, Heritage and the Gaeltacht, Jimmy Deanahan, spoke about the importance of the exhibition.
I think it's very important to remember and also to show solidarity with the families of the 3,000 people who were killed in 9/11. And I suppose here in Ireland, to show solidarity with the Irish connections. New York is very close to Ireland, and a large number of Irish people have lived in New York over the years, and they have very close affinity and affection for the place. So I think this event is very significant. Also, I think we probably would be one of the few countries now that would have an exhibition such as this. So I think that's very important as well, and we are sending out a strong message to our friends in New York and the USA that we sympathise and we empathise with those people who were killed, and I think that's very important. These people should never be forgotten. Another aspect to it, I suppose, it changed the mindset, I think, in both the USA and even here in this country on terrorism and the havoc that terrorism can wreak upon people. And certainly I think that there was a whole new mindset after 9/11 towards terrorism, both in the USA and also here in this country as well.
As part of the exhibition, two fallen heroes from 9/11 with Irish connections, police officer Moira Smith of the New York Police Department and firefighter Kevin O'Rourke of the Fire Department of New York were honoured. A number of family members were in attendance and spoke about what it meant to them.
It brought a lump to my throat, you know, just to, you know, to walk around and look at the photos and you know, brought me back to, you know, to that day, you know, and showing Patricia, you know, some of the devastation, you know, she was too little to remember it, you know, pointing out different things in different places, you know, where her mom was, you know, when the tower came down and. You know, things of that nature, and then the wall of all the remembrances of people looking for their lost relatives and, you know, loved ones. To me, that's always the most, you know, heart, you know, hurting thing, most painful to, you know, to look at those. You know, Moira had her family put up, you know, her cousins came in, they all put up signs all over the city too, you know, which I wasn't aware of at the time. You know, I found out afterwards, you know, that I had seen a flyer from Moira And you know, that always, to me, is you know, the most disturbing you know, part of any kind of exhibit like this. But also, it, you know, it brings it all home.
I enjoyed all, every part of it. Her little like section of it, it was really nice. It was with her hat and everything, just because that's like such a like home, like it's a really close piece to home. And it just, it means a lot. I'm proud to represent my mom and to like hear what people have to say about her with all the great things she's done on 9/11.
It was a great honor to have him represented in such a peaceful and really family kind of way. You know, we've come a long way in meeting Paul and Nicola, and even Paul's family came and had tea and met Grin, and it's really, it's a good honor.
It's very personal, very very respectfully done. I feel it was nice that the people of Ireland were so involved in everything about the museum exhibit and even respectfully 9/11. It's important that all people realize that remembrance is what hopefully it doesn't happen again, that it can happen anywhere. We were someone that it happened to, but you want to remember so that it, you can maybe hopefully learn from it and not ever see something like this again.
The moving nature of the exhibition and its significance were highlighted by Irish television celebrity Dahi O'Shea.
I think it's hard to believe that it's been 10 years since 9/11, probably one of the biggest catastrophes that hit the world. Also, I think it was quite amazing, a world event that actually happened live in television. I think that's probably the biggest thing about it. The exhibition is absolutely unreal altogether. I think the first thing you see when you go inside the door on the left-hand side is all the missing people and all those posters. You'd often see them all around the place, but to have them all up on one wall. And these are actually families who have lost people, or who lost people during 9/11. And still, you know, these people have been missing, bodies haven't been found, bodies haven't been identified, and these people still, you know, have it right in their hearts that these people were caught up in this event. And just to see some of the pictures there of the day itself, the smoke rising up over New York, a big cloud of smoke and smoot, as they say in Irish, all over Manhattan. It's absolutely unreal. I think the exhibition catches it and captures the event as it happened just quite brilliantly.
The master of ceremonies at the launch, leading Irish broadcaster Ryan Tubridy, was clearly impressed by the exhibition. Encouraging people to attend, he spoke of its significance to people of all ages.
What I will take is word to give to other people to come and see it. And I say that because, as we talked to Patricia inside, 12 years old, she was only a little child, 2 years old when her mother died in this tragedy. It's people like her should come and see this. 12-year-olds, 15-year-olds, 18-year-olds, because they are the harbours in which history will lie now. And it's up to them to go away and tell the story of what happened, because as we, people like me, get a bit older and just start telling stories, we'll just be bores. But the kids have to come here and see this, to know that it's real, to read the names, look at the pictures, to sense the photographs, to hear the sounds, to acknowledge the chaos, the sadness, the unbearable grief. Take it away and say, yeah, I saw it, it did happen, it's true. And keep the memory and the story of these people and this city alive.
McCormick feels that it's very important for people in Ireland to visit the exhibition.
I just hope that a lot of people that are in Dublin come to see this exhibition. It's a very emotional exhibition. It's very powerful, but it's an important message that we're trying to get across, to keep the memory alive and never forget that terrible day. And I hope the people of Ireland that are in Dublin come here to experience it the way a lot of people did here tonight.
The Ground Zero 360 Degrees exhibition runs in the National Museum of Ireland, Collins Barracks, until October 1st. Chris Ashmore, Wallace Media, Dublin.